Good evening.
各位晚上好。
It's been a wonderful evening of good food and a time chance of worshiping the Lord together.
今天晚上真的我们有非常美好的时光，能够一起享受世界上各国不同的晚餐，然后在这边享受就好。
But I must confess that I didn't have much of an appetite to eat.
但是我必须承认，今天晚上我的这个食量不是特别好。
Because colleagues gave me a very challenging task.
因为有人给我一个非常这个沉重的托付。
And that is to preach in English.
就是用英语来讲道。
I actually do not preach in English very often.
我个人不怎么讲道。
And every time I have the opportunity of speaking in English,
每次当我有机会用英语来讲道的时候
I'm reminded of an experience I had, and this was a number of years ago in the city of Philadelphia.
我总是想起曾经有一次在菲拉德尔菲亚那个城市发生的事儿。
I was invited to a Chinese church in Philadelphia to speak at their mission conference.
那一次我被邀请在一个教会里面，那是一个特别的这个宣教的聚会。
Very similar to our weekend here, Friday night service, Saturday night service, and then Sunday morning.
非常类似于我们这几天所经历的。
Well, on the first evening, they asked if I could speak in Mandarin Chinese, and of course, I was very happy to do that.
第一个晚上他们让我用中文来讲道，当然我义不容辞。
And of course, it was translated, and so I was speaking in Chinese, and Chinese was translating it into English.
所以那一次呢，我就用中文讲道，然后有一位华人的弟兄就用英语帮我翻译。
And I'm sure it was rather disconcerting for many people to see a 外楼 speaking Mandarin, a 老外 speaking Mandarin, and a 老中 speaking English.
所以在那一期呢，大家觉得很奇怪，怎么会有一个 foreigner speaking English, 然后那个一个中 foreigner speaking Chinese, 然后一个中国人 speaking English.
Well, the second evening they asked if I could preach in English.
那第二天晚上他要求我用英语讲道。
I think they wanted to find out if I could speak English at all.
他们要看到我是不是能够用英语讲道。
So I'm not sure, maybe that's the intent of Irvine Church as well.
也许他们是这样子，要看看我能不能用英语。
I actually thought I did a very good job in speaking in English that evening.
事实上我回想那一次我用英语讲道大概还行。
Until after the service, somebody came up.
直到聚会完了以后有人
said to me, Pastor Taylor, I heard you speak in Mandarin yesterday, and I heard you speak in English this evening.
他就说昨天晚上我听到你用中文讲道，今天晚上我听您用英文。
And I have but one conclusion.
我有一个结论。
English is not your mother tongue.
英语不是你自己的母语。
So I have lived under that shadow ever since.
所以呢，从那开始呢，我就有那个阴影在我心里。
So you pray for me, and we trust the Lord will help us to get through this evening.
因此呢，我请各位为我祷告，然后我开始用英语讲道，特别为我祷告，因为今天站在我旁边的讲员，他的中文、英文都比我好。
Bibles, would you turn together with me to the book of Acts?
如果我们有圣经的话，请我们一起翻到《使徒行传》。
The book of Acts, we want to look at the fourth chapter of the book of Acts, looking especially at several verses, verse 13, and then skipping down to verse 29, 30, and 31.
我们要来看几处的圣经，我们要看第四章十三节，然后呢，我们要翻到后面看到十九节，还有。
Acts chapter 4, beginning in verse 13.
如果我们一起翻到的话呢，我们来一起看第四章第十三节。
Luke recording this.
路加他这样做记录。
When they saw the courage of Peter and John.
当他们那些人见到彼得的胆量和约翰的胆量。
If you're familiar with this passage, you'll know that they there refers to the religious leaders. In Jerusalem.
如果各位熟悉这段圣经的背景的话，各位晓得这里说的他们是指的当时在那个地方的那些聚会教会的那些领袖们。
When they saw the courage of Peter and John and realized they were unschooled, ordinary men, they were astonished that they and they took note that these men had been with Jesus.
当他们见彼得、约翰的胆量，又看出他们原是没有学问的小灵，就稀奇，认明他们是跟过耶稣的。
If you brought your own Bible and you don't mind marking in your Bible, perhaps you can circle that word courage, or in some translations, boldness. They saw the courage, the boldness of Peter and John.
如果各位有带自己的圣经，而又不介意在圣经上做笔记的话呢，在这个地方您可以十三节地方，彼得、约翰的胆量，就把胆量给画起来，因为有些翻译说到是胆量，有的地方翻译成大胆。
To jump down to verse 29 and verse 30.
然后我们就看到第二十九节和第三十节。
Now, Lord, consider their threats and enable your servants to speak your word with great boldness.
这里他们向主祷告，他们说：“现在求主鉴察，以致叫你仆人大胆放胆。”
Stretch out your hand to heal and perform miraculous signs and wonders through the name of your holy servant, Jesus.
伸出你的手来医治疾病，并且使神迹奇事因着你圣仆耶稣的名行出来。
Notice again verse 29. Now, Lord, consider their threats and enable your servants to speak your word with great boldness, and there is that word again.
这里他们向主呼求，他们恐吓我们，所以他们向主求主鉴察，让你的仆人大大的放胆。
And then notice verse 31.
然后看到第三十一节。
After they prayed, the place where they were meeting was shaken, and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and spoke the word of God boldly.
第三十一节说，祷告完了，聚会的地方震动，他们就都被圣灵充满，放胆讲论神的道。
They were filled with the Holy Spirit.
他们就被圣灵充满。
And spoke the word of God with boldness. They spoke the word of God boldly.
放胆讲论神的道。
The title of my message this evening is Boldness to Witness.
今天晚上的题目是说到不能不说
Boldness to witness.
我们要大胆的去见证。
I wonder if I could begin by asking you a question.
我如果可以在开始的时候问各位一个问题。
You don't need to answer it out loud, but answer it in your heart.
当然你不需要直接回答我，但是在你心里面做一个回答。
Would you describe yourself as a courageous Christian or a...less than courageous or a cowardly Christian.
你会如何的形容你自己？是你是一个很勇敢放胆的一个基督徒呢？还是一个没有胆量的基督徒？
Are you a courageous Christian?
你是否是一个有胆量的基督徒？
Or perhaps we are cowardly in our Christian witness.
还是说作为一个基督徒，我们其实没有那么大的胆量？
Now I'm convinced that God is seeking for people who have the boldness and have the courage to witness for Jesus Christ.
我非常相信神今天要的是能够放胆做见证的基督徒。
Recently, I was reading a testimony of a very courageous Christian, a courageous missionary.
最近我在读书的时候读到一个人，他是个非常有胆量的基督徒。
He was actually the first missionary sent to the city of Wenzhou in China.
他是一个当初最早去温州传道的一个基督徒。
His name was George Stark.曹雅池 he was from Scotland.
他的名字是叫 George Stark, 他是来自于苏格兰。
曹雅池。曹雅池。Actually, when he applied to the CIM, the China Inland Mission,
当他申请参加这个中国内地会宣教的
时候 originally they felt that he was unsuited to go to China.
那时候内地会的负责人认为说他不太适合。
But the simple reason was George Stark, he only had one leg. He was handicapped.
其中一个原因是这位曹雅直这位弟兄，他是一个残障人士。
And the CIM leadership said, "You can't go to China with one leg."
然后内地会的弟兄们说，你只有一条腿，你不能过去宣教。
They said, "What would happen if we sent you to China and you went to a city to share the gospel and suddenly there was an uprising?"
如果说我们把你放到那边去宣教，忽然间那边有一些暴动怎么办？
You're not going to be able to outrun the Chinese with just one leg.
到时候你跑都跑不掉。
Well, Well, they were convinced, or George Stott convinced them that God was indeed calling him to China, and so they reluctantly accepted him and sent him to China and sent him as the first missionary to Wenzhou.
但是曹雅芝他就很努力地说服了这些弟兄们，把他们让他们允许他到温州去传道，成为第一个传道人在温州。
It was very interesting how he convinced them.
我很稀奇他到底是怎么样来
说服他们。Because he said to them, "Don't you see all the people with two good legs aren't going, so I have to go."
他怎么样说服的呢？他说：“你没看那些两个脚的人都去了吗？一个脚脚的人也要去。”
两个脚的不去，所以我要去。Well, he was sent to Wenzhou.
然后呢，他们就差派他到温州去。
And I remember just recently reading his biography.
我就注意到，当我在读他的这个传记的时候。
It described how he first got to Wenzhou. There were no Christians in the city of Wenzhou.
但在故事里面，他形容他到了温州的时候，没有一个基督徒。
And actually, I don't think the CIM and the leadership were prophets foretelling that he would encounter difficulty.
我事实上也相信他们也没有那么多的他们也不晓得把这位送到温州以后会遇到多大的麻烦。
But the fact of the matter is, as soon as he arrived in Wenzhou, the Wenzhou people were very, very antagonistic against George Stott.
但事实上，当曹雅芝到了温州的时候，当地的人对他是非常非常的反感的。
They gave him a nickname. I'm not sure how to translate it into English.
他们给他一个小名。
They called him 红毛番人。And they said, "We don't want the gospel here."
他们说我们这里不需要是这个福音。
You need to leave this place.
你必须离开这个地方。
If you do not leave this place, we will kill you.
如果你不离开这地方，我们要杀
你。And so you run for your life.
所以你要赶快跑。
God gave George Stott a sense of humor.
然后呢，但是神给了曹雅芝这个弟兄一个很有幽默的这种回
应。And he responded to the people of Wenzhou.
他怎么样回应呢？
He said, "How can I outrun you with just one leg?"
他说你要杀我，你们要我跑，我怎么能够跑得过你们呢
？I'll just stay here.
我干脆留在这边吧。
And make your job easier.
让你们杀我的时候容易一些。
Well, we don't have time to tell the rest of the story except to say.
当然，这个故事很长，但是最主要的是
that George Stott manifested great boldness.
曹雅芝身上让我们看见的是那样的胆量。
And because of that great boldness,
因着他的胆量
，God greatly used.George Stott to establish the church in Wenzhou.
在那里建立了神的教会。
Actually, if we go to Wenzhou today,
如果我们今天到温州去的话
，and you go to the city downtown of Wenzhou, there is a street called Garden Street, 公园街 Garden Street.
今天我们如果到那个温州的市中心，有一条街叫做 Garden Street, 公园街。
And there is a church that actually was the first church.Started by George Stott.
在那里你会看见一个教堂，那个教堂就是曹雅芝弟兄开始的。
Boldness to witness,
大胆的见证。
I believe that, brothers and sisters, that's not only what God desires of you and me and the church.
但是弟兄姐妹们，我相信神跟我们要的不光是这样子胆量而已。
But I am convinced that the world desperately needs not cowardly Christians.But courageous Christians.
我也相信今天这个世界所需要的看到的是勇敢的基督徒。
The world desperately needs not people who are ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, but rather those who boast in the cross and in the gospel of Jesus Christ.
今天世界不需要的是那些胆小的、不敢传福音的基督徒。今天世界所需要的是能够大胆、放胆讲论耶稣的。
The world desperately needs people.Who have boldness to witness?
今天世界上的人需要的是那些能够放胆为耶稣做见证的。
We read three passages from the Book of Acts.
我们今天在《使徒行传》看了三个章节。
On three different occasions in this one chapter, this word boldness appears.
就在这一个第四章里面， 胆量放胆出现了三次。
And I want to look together with you at these three pictures.
让我们来看这三幅图画。
Because I believe that as we understand these three pictures increasingly, I believe that you and I will also grow in our boldness.
因为我相信，若我们来仔细来鉴赏这三幅图画，了解这三幅图画，或许我们就能够有更大的胆量。
Now, before we look at these three pictures,
在我们来开始看这三幅图画之前,
it's important for us to understand what boldness means.
首先很重要的就是我们要来知道这胆量是什么。
And what it actually doesn't mean as well.
它应该是什么。
Now, if you look in the New Testament,
如果我们看新约圣经里面,
you'll find actually this word boldness in the Greek, in the original, appears 31 times.
你会发现在希腊原文里面这个字出现了31次。
And if we were to go and look at these 31 times,
如果我们去看这31处的圣经,
we would find that actually this word boldness does not mean arrogance.
我们发现这里每一次讲到这个胆量放胆的时候都不是那种骄傲性的。
It means boldness, but it doesn't mean boastfulness.
这不是说那种 很自我扩大自我扩张的。
And certainly boldness does not mean brashness either.
更甚者这个胆量不是说到自我的膨胀。
It doesn't mean that somebody is filled with arrogance and despises or looks down on somebody else.
不是一个人他有自己的这个自我膨胀然后看清别人。
I learned that lesson early on in my missionary career in Taiwan.
在我过去在台湾传福音的早期的时候我就学到这个功课。
I remember standing in line waiting to get on a bus one time.
我记得有一次我在排队等这个公车。
And standing beside me was a gentleman.
在我旁边有一个男士站。
And so I struck up a conversation with him.
所以我就开始跟他交谈。
And of course I explained that I was a Christian. I asked him if he had ever been to church before.
当然我就跟他介绍说我是个基督徒然后问他有没有去过教会。
I said no.No, I am a Buddhist. I do not go to church.
我没有去过教会，我是一个佛教徒。
Well, I then asked him the following question.
接着我就问下一个问题。
I said, that's very interesting. You say you are a Buddhist.
你说你是个基这个佛教徒。
I wonder if you can explain to me what it means when somebody says they are a Buddhist.
我就是说，如果你可以帮我解释一下，当有人说他自己是佛教徒的时候，这是什么意思
？And it became apparent immediately that my question had stumped him.
立刻我就发现这样是一个简单的问题让他不知道如何回答。
He did not know how to answer that question.
他完全不知道怎么样回应这个问题。
And so I looked at him and I said, well, isn't that funny? You say you are a Buddhist, but you don't know what you mean, what you believe in.
我说这不是很有意思吗？你说你是个佛教徒，但是你不晓得佛教徒是什么。
Don't you think that is a bit ironic to believe in something you don't know what you believe in?
你不觉得很有意思吗？你说你是什么，但是你不晓得那是什么。
Well, let me tell you what I believe in.
让我反过来告诉你我相信的是什么。
And it was with a degree, and I confess before God, it was a degree with a degree of arrogance that I had the boldness to witness that day.
但是在那一瞬间，我忽然发现我这里面有一个骄傲。
And you can imagine that kind of witness is actually not too effective.
当然你知道这样子一种心态的为主见证
And he did not get into the kingdom of God that day at least through Jamie Taylor's witness.
如果靠着那种态度去传福音的话你不会带领任何人
And so that's not the boldness that we are talking about this
day. 所以在这里今天晚上我们讲到的放胆不是那样子的
It is not boastfulness nor is it brashness or arrogance or pride.
这绝对不是那种自我膨胀自我陶醉自以为意
But rather it is a deep and yet humble confidence in knowing what we believe.
然而这是一个非常内在非常确定的知道说我们信的是什么。
And the courage, yes, as Peter tells us, to share the good news of Jesus Christ out of a spirit of gentleness and yet out of a spirit of conviction.
而且正如彼得所教我们的我们所分享的是从我们内里面出来的很确信的知道，并且带着那种温柔的心带出来的信息。
Well, where did the disciples' courage come from?
那么使徒们他们的胆量从何而来
？Well, if your Bibles are still open, let's look at verse 13.
如果我们的圣经仍然翻开的话，我们来看第四章第十一节。
第十三节，
对不起，第十三节。
There we see Luke describing it for us this way.
路加为我们做了一个很好的形容。
He said, when they saw the courage of Peter and John, they realized that they were unschooled and ordinary people.
这里说他们见彼得和约翰的胆量，就看出他们原来是没有学问的小民。
And they were astonished. And they took note that these men, and notice this phrase, they took note that these men had been with Jesus.
他们就注意到认明这些人是跟过耶稣的。
Now I want us to notice first of all.
首先
That the disciples' boldness did not come from what they knew, but rather it came from who they knew.
首先，我们发现一个很重要的，就是使徒们他们的胆量并非来自于学问，而是来自于他们所认识的是谁。
Their boldness did not come from what they knew.
他们的胆量不是来自于他们的学问。
We're told actually there that they were unschooled and they were just ordinary people.
因为这里证明他们原来是没有学问的小民。
Actually, the original there has the meaning of being an idiot.
事实上，在原文里面，这个没有学问的小民还有一层的意义，就是基本上是愚民。
And that these religious leaders looked upon these people as unschooled with no education. Chinese we say 土包子。They were idiots.
那些宗教领袖们认明知道他们这是一群没有读过书没有学问的人。
And yet it's interesting. It wasn't from what they knew that they got courage.
然而有意思的地方是他们的胆量并非来自于这些学问。
But rather it came from who they knew.
反而是来自于他们所认识的是谁。
And of course that reminds us of an important truth in our faith.
当然这件事情就提醒我另外一个我们信仰里面一个重要的地方。
The faith of Jesus Christ is not so much a religion as it is a relationship.
我们在基督的信仰里面这个基督信仰的中心不是一个宗教而是一个关系。
It is not a religion.
这宗教。
Rather, it is a relationship with a person, and that person's name is Jesus Christ.
我们在基督的信仰里面，这不是一个宗教，而是我们与基督耶稣的关系。
Now, before you walk out of this place and tell everybody that Jamie Taylor is against education, I need to pause.
如果各位在这个点上有开始有误解，说我个人是反对教育的话呢，那我必须先停一下。
I am not saying that theological education or getting a Bible degree is against scripture.
在这里，我并不是说神学教育或者是得到那些神学的训练是反圣经的。
I see we need to be ordinary people. We need to be unschooled.
好像说我们必须都跟他们一样成为一般的不用读书的人
I'm not saying that at all. There is a role for a theological education.
我绝对不是这么说我的意思我相信神学教育有它的作用
But let us not fool ourselves by assuming just because you get a theological education therefore you will also get boldness.
但是我们必须要小心不能有这个误解那就是说如果我有神学的教育那么我自然就有见证的胆量
You could go to the best of seminaries and still come away not a courageous Christian but rather perhaps a still cowardly Christian
你完全可以 从一个非常有名的神学院毕业但是你不一定会从那里面出来以后成为一个勇敢的能够见证神的
And so these disciples, their boldness came not from what they knew, but who they knew.
因此再一次我说他们这些人能够为主见证不是来自于他们的学问而是来自于他们认识的是谁。
Well, look at it. Let's look at this phrase a little more closely.
那我们再仔细再看这一段圣经。
They noted that they were unschooled, ordinary people.
所以他们已经被认出来是一群没有读书没有学问的人。
But then he goes on to say that they took note that they had been with Jesus.
但是那时候的领袖们就同样的发现另外一件事情，这些人肯定是跟过耶稣。
And so it would seem to me that, first of all, the disciples' boldness came from the fact that they were in the presence of Jesus.
因此我们发现一件很重要的一个内涵就是这些门徒们的胆量来自于耶稣基督的同在。
It was as they often found themselves in the presence of Jesus that they got that courage from being in his presence.
就好像这些基督徒们，这些门徒们，因为他们一直在神的同在里面，因此他们有那从神来的那种胆量。
Now I reflected upon the presence of Jesus a bit, and I want to share very quickly three things that came to mind.
让我们来思考，耶稣的同在这件事情。
What did it mean, and how did the disciples get courage and boldness out of being in the presence of Jesus?
一个基督徒，一个门徒，如何能够从耶稣基督同在这件事情上面得到力量，得到胆量？
Well, I was struck first of all. I first of all thought of the fact that Jesus' presence was a modeling presence for the disciples.
首先，耶稣基督同在这件事情上，他自己做了表率。
It was a modeling presence，
因为他自己告诉我们什么是他的同在。
And what I mean by that is Jesus set a model for the disciples。
也就是说，他自己做了一个例子。
And they followed in that model。
然后让他的门徒们跟着这个他的所做的这个表率来
走。And as they saw Jesus。And the example of Jesus.
他们看见耶稣他自己所做的。
They immediately saw that actually during Jesus' ministry, he also encountered opposition.
他们就看见耶稣基督在他的服事过程里面，也同样的遭遇到很多的阻拦。
We can't go back into the book of the Gospels, but if you're familiar, you'll read over and over again how people opposed what Jesus shared.
各位如果记得在福音书里面有多少次有多少人反对耶稣。
And so actually to a point, it was so antagonistic that you remember they crucified Jesus.
让那么多人反对耶稣，到了最后他们把耶稣挂在十字架上。
And so as the disciples followed in that example of Jesus,
所以他们在耶稣基督身上看见了这一切。
Their hearts were prepared just as people opposed Jesus.They are going to also oppose us.
他们心里就有了预备，他们知道说，如果他们跟耶稣基督走同样的路，会有许多的人反对他们。
And so when opposition came to the disciples, on the one hand, they did not need to be surprised.
所以一方面，当这些门徒在外面传福音的时候，有这么多人反对他们，他们不一定会觉得。
At the same time, they could have the boldness that Jesus also had.
他们能够从神那里，从耶稣的身上看见神与我们的同在。
Let me just pause there very quickly.
让我稍微停顿一下。
If you're familiar with the book of Acts, you'll actually know that chapter 3 and 4 are very significant in Luke's writing of Acts.
如果各位对《使徒行传》有稍微多一点认识的话，会发现第三章跟四章，路加写这三章跟四章的时候是有特别的用意的，特性的。
You remember that the disciples healed a man who was born lame in chapter 3.
在第三章里面记载了有一个人生来是瘸腿的。
And then they went into the temple and they began to preach about Jesus who healed this man, 40-year-old man.
那个人已经是四十岁了，躺在那边不能行走。然后使徒们到了殿里面要去祷告的时候，为他祷告。
And then in chapter 4, Luke describes for us actually the first instance of religious persecution of the Christian church in all of history.
当他们为这个瘸腿生来瘸腿人祷告，而那个人奉着耶稣的名得了医治之后，到了第四章，我们就看见第一次的门徒的。这个福音的工作受到了逼迫。
There, the religious leaders got up and they said, "You cannot speak in the name of Jesus anymore."
宗教的领袖们就很愤怒地说，你们不可以再奉耶稣的名来传道。
And they threw Peter and John into prison.
然后就把他们抓起来。
You know, as I read down through this account,
当我来读这段故事的时候
，I was struck by two things, just very quickly.
我忽然发现两件事情。
You know, so often when we share the gospel today.
我们今天很多时候我们说传福音
we encounter people who can't accept the gospel.
我们也遇到很多人说我没有办法接受。
And of course, if we probe a little further, they tell us that, well, you know, we're educated now. We live in the 21st century.
当你仔细问他们的时候，很多人说我受高等教育的，我不需要这个。
We don't believe in those old wives' tales anymore.
我们不再相信这些故事了。
And so some people are against the gospel of Jesus Christ because they believe that we are modern people, we are liberated people, we are educated people.
很多人就说自以为说我们今天是活在这个世纪里面，我们是受高等教育的，我们不需要这种莫名其妙的。
Well, you might be modern, you might be liberated, you might be educated.
也许你是现代的人，你也许就是解放了，也许你已经受过高等教育了。
But opposition to the gospel of Jesus Christ did not. in the 21st century.
但是反对耶稣基督福音不是在这个世纪开始的。
2000 years ago, people who were educated also opposed the gospel.
两千年前那些受当时高等教育的人也同样的反对他们的所传的福音。
And so opposition to the gospel, if you would allow me to say so, is nothing new.
但因此我们知道我们今天若是听到任何反对的声浪，那一点都不是新鲜事。
And you might say, well, it's because I'm educated that I don't believe in the gospel.
你会听到有人说，因为我是受高等教育的，因此我不相信福音。
Well, 2000 years ago, people didn't believe in the gospel.
两千年前有人说过同样的话。
Regardless of what they were educated in.
不管他是什么样的教育。
But isn't it interesting, actually, if you look at their opposition to the gospel?
但是你看他们对圣经的反对的时候，
it was actually quite illogical.
事实上，他们反对的逻辑是不完整的。
Actually, if your Bibles are still open, look at several verses with me very quickly.
我们来看很有意思的地方。
You remember that they saw the courage of Peter and John there in verse 13.
刚才在十三节的时候，这些领袖们看见这些传福音的人。
In verse 14, we're told that since they could see the man who had been healed standing there with them, that is, this man that was healed was standing right there with Peter and John.
他们看见这个四十几岁的人生来瘸腿的被医治好了，与彼得、约翰站在一处。
And notice this phrase: there was nothing that they could say.
因此呢，他们就无话可说。
But they couldn't say he was not miraculously healed.
他们不能够跟别人说他这个人没有被医治，或者说他不是靠神迹医治的。
This is only a figure of your imagination.
他不能够说这是完全你们想象的，这个人其实没有受医治。
They're just playing tricks on our eyes.
也许是因为他们使用什么幻术，让我们以为他得了医治。
He was this man standing there, and there was nothing that they could do.
不，这个人是活生生的站在他们的面前，因此他们无话可说。
But look on what else they said.
他们又说什么呢？
And so they ordered them to withdraw from the Sanhedrin and to confer together. Verse 15.
第十五节，于是吩咐他们从公会出去。
What are we going to do with these men? They said.
他们彼此商议说，我们当怎样办这二人？
Everyone living in Jerusalem knows they have done an outstanding miracle.
因为他们诚然行了一件明显的神迹。
And then notice this phrase.
然后注意这里。
And we cannot deny it.
而我们也不能说没有发生过。
Isn't it amazing? The illogical myths of unbelief.
看到这里，他们想要反对，但他反对的理由是
不完。Even with the evidence.
当他们看见了证据。
So convincing.
完完整整的证据在他面前。
Nothing I can say.
我不能够说什么反驳的话。
I cannot deny the fact.
我不能够反对这个我所亲眼见到的。
打死我，我还是不行。I will not, absolutely not believe.
我还是觉得我不能相信。
The illogicalness.
这种不合逻辑的心态
of unbelief.
不合逻辑的心态。
And I was struck by the fact.
然后我就发现
well, there might be intellectual hurdles to accept the gospel.
也许有些人有这个逻辑上的问题，说我因为学术，因为学问的程度，我认为说我不能够相信圣经。
Ultimately, the cause of unbelief is not intellectual.
集中一个人能不能够接受圣经，不是学问，
it was emotional.
而是他的心态。
It's not a problem so much of the head,
不是脑袋里想的东西，
as it is of the heart.
而是心态里面的东西。
Jesus modeled.
所以耶稣做了一个表率。
And as they saw Jesus face opposition,
当门徒们看见耶稣是怎么样走过这条路，
their hearts were prepared.
他们的心是预备好的。
And I just quickly also say,
然后在这里我再说。
I believe that in this generation you and I live in,
我相信在这个世代里面，
we will increasingly face opposition.
我们将会面临更多的反对的声浪。
To be a true follower of Jesus Christ,
作为一个真正耶稣基督的跟随，
will not get easier and easier.
我们若真正的跟随他，我们的日子并不会越来越轻省容易。
It will become more and more difficult.
反而是越来越艰难。
The 20th century,
在这二十一世纪。
The 20th century,
第二十世纪。
There were more Christians martyred for the Christian faith than all of the centuries before added together.
在二十世纪的时候， 所有为主殉道的人的总数加起来超过过去的时代加起来的人数。
And I believe that the 21st century will not change.
而今天在21世纪可能会更。
So we often need Jesus' presence.
所以我们更多的需要耶稣的同在。
Because boldness signifies opposition.
因为我们越放胆，我们就越会看见
反对。If there is no opposition, we do not need boldness.
如果没有这个反对的力量，你就不需要放胆。
And so, first of all, it was Jesus' modeling presence.
所以首先我们看见耶稣为我们做了表率。
But secondly, I also believe it was Jesus' molding presence.
再来，我相信主耶稣基督他在塑造我们来。经历来认识他的同在。
And what I mean by that is, as the disciples experienced the transforming power of Jesus Christ in their lives, their lives were molded, their lives were transformed, their lives were changed.
我很相信主耶稣在我们身上，在他的门徒身上做的是一个改变的塑造的工作，能够让我们能够活在他的同在里面。
And as they experienced Jesus' touch in their lives were changed.And they had a message that they had to tell.
当基督徒们能够经历神的手摸在他们生活里面，他的生命当中，他们就有那个胆量，能够放胆宣扬。
Look back at what Luke tells us.
我们来看看路加又跟我们说了。
You remember that they called Peter and John back into the Sanhedrin.
你就记得我们刚才看到他们把他们这个彼得跟约翰又叫回来。
And verse 18, they called them and they say to them, and they command them not to speak in the or to teach in.At all in the name of Jesus.
把他们叫过来以后呢，就告诉他们说，禁止他们说，总不可奉耶稣的名讲论。
And then notice what verse 19 says.
然后十九节怎么说
？Peter and John replied like this.
彼得约翰说
，They said, "Judge for yourselves whether it is right in God's eye to obey you or to obey God."
听从你们，不听从神，这在神面前合理不合理，你们自己酌量吧。
I like verse 20.
我很喜欢第二十节。
They go on to say, for we cannot help but speak about what we have seen and what we have heard.
他们说，因为我们所看见、所听见的，不能不说。
There is where I got the Chinese title for my message.
这里就是我们今天的中文的这个信息的主题。
Boldness to witness.
不能不说。
We cannot.But speak of what we have experienced.
我们所看见、所听见的，我们实在不能不说。
Oh, brothers and sisters, I pray that we would experience Jesus in such a way.
我多么希望我们每个人都能够从这样子来经历神，让我们经历到一种程度，我们不能不说。
In a personal way.
是一个非常个人的经历。
In a real way.
在一个非常真实的经历里面。
In a transforming way.
一个改变的经历里面。
That we could go with hearts of flame to share.About the gospel of Jesus Christ with boldness,
使我们的里面焚烧的、燃烧的，让我们不能不出去向别人宣扬。
Remember, Mark in his gospel tells a wonderful story in chapter 5.
你记得在马可福音第五章里面说的故事。
Jesus went across the Sea of Galilee.
耶稣过了这个加利利。
And he met a man who, for many many years had been, been demon possessed.
结果过了加利利海以后，到了这个地方，有一个人跑过来，他是多年被鬼附的。
People had sought to control him.
有多少人想要用各种方法把这个给绑住？
They put chains around him.
用锁链把他锁住。
But he broke off the chains.
但是那个人用超人的力量把这些东西绑住。
And no matter how they tried to use these chains to imprison him, he broke out of all of them.
不管他们用各种方法想要把他给绑起来、关起来，通通没有办法。
Remember, he then meets Jesus.
最后他遇到了耶稣。
And you have a wonderful, a beautiful picture of the transforming gospel.
在那里你看到一个非常非常美丽的图画，一个改变生命的图画。
Jesus sends the demons out. You remember, he sends them into a herd of pigs.
耶稣就把这些鬼通通赶出去。你记得他把他赶到一群的那个猪的身上。
The people of the town come.
但那个当地的人都跑来了。
And they see this man who formerly was possessed.By legions, by many many demons.
他们今天跑来了，说怎么回事？他们知道这个人身上有许许多多的鬼沉浸在他身上。
This man was sitting there in his right mind.
但是这个人现在坐在那边，安安静静，脑筋清清楚楚。
Fear came over the people.
忽然间惧怕就临到这些周围的人。
They beg Jesus to leave.
他们不晓得怎么回事，他们因此求耶稣赶快离开。
Well, if you go back and read that account,
如果你回去再读那个故事，
you remember that this man begged also, begged that he might go with Jesus.
但另外一个被那个鬼被赶出去的这个人，他同样也求耶稣，求耶稣带他。
But Jesus said no.
耶稣说不。
Rather, what I want you to do.
但是我要你做的。
I want you to go back. I want you to go back to your town.
我要你回到你的城镇里。
And tell the people.
告诉他们。
The great work of deliverance that you have experienced.
告诉他们，你所经历在你生命里面经历的这伟大的神迹。
And so Mark tells us that he went.
马可福音里面告诉我们，他回去。
And because he experienced that molding presence,
因为他所经历的是那塑造的改变的。神迹来自于耶稣的。
He had boldness.
他因此能够放胆来见证。
Jesus is modeling presence.
所以耶稣他为我们做表率。
Jesus is molding presence.
他也为我们做改变塑造。
But very quickly, I think also Jesus is motivating presence.
还有一个很重要的是，耶稣一直在激励我们。
You can imagine it's sometimes very difficult to introduce me as a speaker.
你知道有时候要介绍我做作为一个讲员是不是很容易
？Because you can't just introduce Jamie Taylor.
因为你不能够总是介绍他就是 Jamie Taylor 牧师。
You have to begin five generations ago.
每次他要介绍我的时候，要从我五代以前的这个是曾祖父开始。
And if I can be deathly honest with you, sometimes the chairperson of the meeting spends more time talking about Hudson Taylor than he does about me.
然后就说这介绍人花了很多的篇幅，很多的时间。介绍那个戴德森，然后花一点点时间介绍。
To the point, I'm not sure who's actually speaking. Hudson Taylor, Jamie Taylor.
有时候我真不晓得是戴德森在讲要讲到呢，还是我要讲到。
Of course, when they introduce Hudson Taylor, they speak about Hudson Taylor.
但是每次他们讲戴德森的时候
，They always like to use a phrase that Hudson Taylor said.
他们总喜欢提到戴德森曾经说过的。
He actually wrote to his sister, who together with his brother-in-law were living in England.
他曾经写信给他的姐姐。
妹妹。Very good. And in this letter, this is what he said.
在这信里面他这么说。
He said, if I had 1,000 lives,
我若有1,000条生命
，I would give it all to Jesus.
我1,000条全部要给。
If I had 1,000 pounds,
如果我有1,000英镑
，I would not withhold one and not give it to China.
我一点都不会留下，全部都要给中国。
And so often, when they use that saying, they stop right there.
很多时候，他们介绍到这里的时候就停住了。
And when I go up, I have to add to that sentence because that really wasn't what Hudson Taylor said entirely.
然后每次我上台的时候，总要把下一句来讲完。
Because actually, what he went on to say, I believe, was more important.
因为我相信。戴德森在后面讲的那一段更重要。
He said, "Yes, if I had 1,000 pounds, China could have them all."
是的，我如果有1,000英镑，中国可以全数拿去。
If I had 1,000 lives, I would give them all to China.
我若有1,000条生命，我全部都要献给中国。
But he went on to say,
但是他又说
"No, not China, but Christ."
不是中国，而是为了基督。
Not China.
一切都是为了基督。
Can we do too much for such a savior?
我们为了这样的一个荣耀的救主，我们
会嫌做的嫌太多。
我们能够做的会嫌太多。
Can we do too much for such a savior?
我们为这样的救主所做的会嫌太多。
Jesus is.Motivating presence.
耶稣基督他的同在，他一直不断的激励我们。
And I believe, brothers and sisters, when you and I are often found in the presence of Jesus,
弟兄姐妹们，我相信我们常常发现我们在主的同在里面，
自然而然
，naturally
we will have boldness.
Naturally, 我们会有胆量。
We will have boldness to witness.
我们会有为他做见证的胆量。
And so it was the presence of Jesus that gave the disciples boldness.
是耶稣基督同在给了他们这样子的感觉。
Well, let's look on, because it wasn't, only, it wasn't only the presence of Jesus, but secondly, it was also the power of God.
其实不光是耶稣基督同在，这还不够，还有就是神的能力。
The power of God also gave them boldness to witness.
同样给了他们力量和胆量来传福音。
In the second passage that we read, verse 29 and 30, it actually comes at the very end of a prayer that the disciples uttered.
在这个时候，他们做完了一个祷告。
You remember that Peter and John were released.
你记得那个时候呢，他们被放出来。
And so in verse 23, we're told that they went back to their own people.
所以在第二十三节，他们回到他们的会堂。
They reported all that the chief priests and the elders had said to them.
把祭司长和长老所说的话都告诉了他们。
And then in verse 24, Luke tells us, when they heard this, that is, the Christians heard this, they raised their voices together in prayer to God.
当基督徒们听见了他们的报告，就同心合意的高声向神说。
And then in the verses that follow, we have this magnificent prayer of these disciples.
他们就说了一个很好的祷告，在那个祷告之后，我们就看到了二十九节。
Incidentally, I wonder if you've ever had the same thought strike you.
我不晓得各位有没有同样的经历过。
You know, sometimes when I read the prayers in the Bible,
有时候当我们在读圣经里面所记载的这个祷告的时候
，the prayers of many of David's psalms,
有时候比方说像大卫的祷告
，or Moses's prayer,
或者摩西的祷告
，or other people's prayer,
或者其他人的祷告
，or even the prayer here,
甚至这里我们看到的祷告。
You know, I must confess to you, sometimes when I read these prayers, I feel a sense of guilt.
有时候我必须承认，我看这些祷告的时候，我自己里面有一个罪恶感。
Or maybe a sense of condemnation.
事实上我有点这个被指责。
And what I mean by that is, when I read these prayers, it just seems that Jamie Taylor's prayers are often quite shallow.
有时候我读完他们祷告的时候，我就发现我自己祷告是这么的肤浅。
Oh yes, Jesus, bless my day.
主啊，求你祝福我这一天。
Bless my family.
祝福我的家庭。
Help my kids in their education.
帮助我的孩子，他们在努力读书。
Don't misunderstand me. All of those things are very nice.
当然，这些都是很好的祷告。
But I must confess to you that so often Jamie Taylor's prayer life is stuck at that level.
但是我必须承认，很多时候我的祷告就是这样的肤浅，就在这个程度，这个层次上面。
If you read this prayer that they pray that Luke records for us,
如果你看到这里的祷告。
We see the depth in their prayer.
我们看见一个深度。
It's actually quite an amazing thing.
其实非常的让人惊讶。
Well, it would seem to me that actually the primary focus is upon the power of God.
因为我们看见祷告里面一个中心的求就是神的力量。
And it was that power actually that gave them increased boldness to witness.
因为只有从神来的力量能够让他们能够放胆。
Very quickly, three things with regard to the power of God. Notice first of all how they refer to God in their prayer.
他们在祷告里面怎么样形容上帝？
They begin by saying in verse 24, Sovereign Lord, you made the heaven and earth and sea and everything in them.
这里说到上主说伟大的神啊，你是造天地海和其中万物的。
They refer to God's creating power.
他们形容的上帝，他们所面对的上帝是那创造的上帝。
They were reminded of the fact that their God was not just some territorial God.
他们常常被提醒，他们的神不是一个当地的小小的一个神明。
Their God wasn't an idol that needed to be carried from here to there, that had eyes but could not see, that had ears but could not hear, that had a mouth but could not speak, who had arms but could not reach out, who had legs but could not walk.
他们要常常被提醒，他们的神不是一个偶像，被拿来放去，在那边眼不能见，耳不能听，手不能动，脚不能行。
But rather, their God was the creator of heaven and earth.
然而一开始他们就强调他们的神，他们所面对的神是那创造宇宙的神。
You know, sometimes I cannot help but wonder whether our timidity.Actually, might come from the fact that we forget how great our God is.
有时候我不得不想，有时候我们的胆小是否来自于我们不认识我们的神是那样伟大的神？
Our timidity comes from the fact that our God is too small.
我们的胆小是否是因为我们以为我们的神就是那么小？
Or else, I should say, the God in our minds and in our hearts is too small.
或者说，我们以为我们所知道的，在我们脑袋里面和我们心里面所认识的是那么小的神。
Perhaps it is the fact that we forget that this God is the creator of heaven and earth.
很可能我们常常忘记我们的神是那创造宇宙万物的神。
And because we forget that,
因为我们忘了
are filled with fear.
因此我们心里面充满了恐惧。
Do you remember the story of Rahab in the Old Testament?
各位如果还记得拉合在旧约的那个故事。
Do you remember her story? It's told to us actually in the book of Joshua.
在约书亚记里面所记载的。
Joshua had sent two spies to the city of Jericho.
那时候约书亚送了两个探子进入敌境耶利哥城。
And lo and behold, Rahab protected these two spies.
拉合决定要保护这两个探子。
Actually, if you think about it,
如果你仔细想想看
she risked her life by doing that, did she not?
她这么样做是不是把她自己生命放在一个很危险的地方
The king of Jericho came to her house.
他们来到了耶利哥城来到
said, where are the spies that came to your house?
当地的人就跑到她家来说哎，听说有探子过来他们在哪里
And Rahab said, well, I think they've already left.
拉合说、哦、我想他们大概已经离开了
Actually, I think they were upstairs.
事实上探子仍然躲在楼上
And she actually exhibited great boldness in protecting those two spies.
拉合为了要保护这两个探子他必须有多么大的胆量
Well, if you get the chance this evening, go home and read what Rahab says to those two spies.
如果各位有时间晚上有兴趣回去再读这段圣经看看拉合里面这个故事所记载的
I think it begins in verse 8 of the second chapter of Joshua.
我相信在第二章第八节开始记载这个事情。
Joshua records for us a message that Rahab gives to the spies.
那么在那里说到拉合他告诉这两个探子。
And in that message, four times over, she refers to God.
一件事情但是他所说的事情里面有四次提到这个神。
She refers to the promise of God.
他提到神的应许
She refers to the power of God.
他讲到神的能力
She refers to the salvation of God.
他讲到神的救恩
But it's very interesting. She also refers to the uniqueness of the God of the Old Testament. The God of the Israelites.
还有一个他讲到神的独特性
I like the Chinese translation there. Rahab refers to the God of Israel as上天下地的神
Rahab described God as a God of heaven and earth
上天下地的神
Exalted heaven and coming down to the world
That was where she got her boldness, brothers and sisters
这样的认识就是能够帮助她有这样子的
She knew that the God of Israel was not an idol like the idols of Jericho
她深深的知道以色列的神不是像当地的神一样就好像是一个破绽
That God was the God of heaven and earth
拉合知道以色列的神是那创造宇宙的神
She was prepared to risk her life the lives of her family
也因此拉合愿意不光是把他自己的性命放上把他全家的性命都放上
From seeing the creating power of God that Rahab had courage
只有一个人看见那创造的能力创造的上帝
And that is how these disciples also had courage.
这些门徒们同样的也因为看到了这样子一个上帝。
And I am certain, brothers and sisters,
我也相信
if we're reminded over and over again,
我们一直不断的被提醒这个故事。
If we are reminded of the greatness of our God,
如果我们常常被提醒我们的神是多么的伟大
I think boldness will come upon us.
我相信在我们生命里面就有很多的这个勇气。
And so it was the creating power of God that gave them boldness.
因为那创造的能力给我们能力。
But secondly, it was also the controlling power of God that gave them boldness.
再一个就是神的这个掌管的能力。
Notice what they say in their prayer beginning in verse 27.
在第二十七节里面他们祷告了。
Now indeed Herod and Pontius Pilate met together with the Gentiles and the people of Israel in this city to conspire against your holy servant Jesus whom you anointed.
二十七节他们祷告希律和本丢比拉多外邦人和以色列民果然在这城里聚集要攻打您所高的圣徒
And then notice what he says in verse 28.
28节说
They did, that is what these people did was what your power and will had decided beforehand should happen.
这些人 所成就的，成就了世上你手和你旨意所预定备有的事。
Not only the creating power of God，
不光我们神是有一个创造的能力
，but the controlling power， the sovereign power of God，
事实上他一个掌管主管的能力。
That there was no accidents。In God's eye，
也因此我们以为很多事情是巧合的时候，事实上神的眼光里面没有巧合。
That the crucifixion of Jesus Christ was not a whoops, I made a mistake。
想想看，耶稣基督被挂在十字架上，并不是哦，圣经说糟糕了。
That, but rather that it was God's will and power that had preordained these things to happen。
事实上，这些现发生的事情，在神的智慧和他的主宰里面、主权里面、掌管里面，完完全全按照他旨意成就的。
My friends，
朋友们
，the controlling power of God，
神掌管的能力
，should give us courage。
应该要，若我们认识的话，就会给我们勇气。
There are no accidents，
没有巧合。
And there are no incidences，
没有碰巧。
But rather, things that happen are by God's allowance，
所有发生事情，神都有定命。
Not accidents，
不是刚好。
Not incidents，
不是碰巧。
But rather providence，
一切事情都有定命。
And I don't know, but you might be going through a time of difficulty。
我不晓得，也许在座有些人刚好生命里面这个时候经历过一些事情。
And there might be things that are happening in your life that I don't know about。
也许在你生活里面遇到的一些事情是我所不知道的。
And there might be difficult。
也许有些困难。
But I want to tell you this evening。
但是今天晚上我愿意在这里跟大家说。
That God in His sovereignty has somehow allowed those things to happen in your life。
神和他的主权。在一定的角度，你必须了解他允许这件事情。
He might be trying to teach you and I lessons。
或许他在教导你一个功课。
And I believe from the bottom of my heart。
但是我深深的相信。
That ultimately God's desire is not to punish。
神最终的目的不是要让你受伤。
But rather to manifest His power。
然而却是在你生命里面，让你看见、见证他的能力。
And it's so often actually in those times of difficulty that our witness becomes all the more powerful, does it not?
事实上，在我们很多最艰难的困苦的时候，我们能够更多的见证看到神自己的荣耀和能力。
Because people can see that this faith of ours is not a fair weather faith.
因为从我们身上那个时候，周围的人就可以看到我们的信心，我们在主里的信心不是一个。一个柔软的心。
We don't deserve the church when things are going well。
我们来到教会，因为我们一切都很好。
And our joy is not a joy that dissipates when difficulties arise。
我们的喜乐不会因为困难来临而解散。
But rather, our joy carries us through those difficulties。
然而，我们里面的喜乐会一直拖着我们，带着我们经过一切的困难。
Boldness to witness。
我们大胆的。
God's creating power，
因为我们有神创造的能力。
God's controlling power，
神的掌管的能力。
Very quickly， also God's confirming power，
神的确立、确定的能力。
This is what they pray，
这是他们的祷告。我们来看一下。
They pray to God. They say，
他们向祷告说
，God， reach out your hand。Verse 30，
第三十节说，求主鉴察，伸出你的手来。
Stretch out your hand to heal。And perform miraculous signs and wonders through the name of your holy servant.
他们怎么样跟主祷告呢？他说：“伸出你的手来，医治疾病，并且使神迹奇事因着你圣父耶稣的名出来，行出来。”
God's confirming power.
神的确立的能力。
And the transformed life.
能够改变生命。改变生命，使成为神的见证。
And as our lives are different because of the gospel.
许许多多人因为圣这个福音的缘故，生命得到改变。
We have the boldness.
因此，我们看到我们就有大胆、放胆的讲道。
So we've seen that their boldness, first of all, comes from Jesus's presence.
首先，因此我们看见门徒们能够放胆，因为他们有神耶稣的同在。
Secondly, we saw that their boldness comes from God's power.
第二，我们看见他们能够放胆，那是因为他们认识神的能力。
But let's look.At the last verse,
然后最后一部分呢，我们来看。
After they had prayed,
当他们祷告完了
，the place where they were meeting was shaken.
聚会的地方震动。
And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit.
他们就都被圣灵充满。
And spoke the word of God. What?
开始放胆讲论神的道。
Boldly.
放胆讲论。
Well, Jesus' presence.
耶稣的同在。
God's power.
神的能力。
And then thirdly.
现在我们看到的是。
The pouring out of the Spirit.
圣灵的浇灌。
The pouring out.
圣灵的浇灌。
Now I need to be very careful what I'm going to say.
当我开始讲圣灵浇灌的时候，我开始要非常的小心。
Because any discussion about the Holy Spirit, especially the baptism of the Holy Spirit, brings us into a certain degree of controversy in the church today.
因为在今天教会里面，很多时候当我们开始讲到圣灵的浇灌的时候呢，就会谈到一些议题，是不是大家都完全一致的？
In my experience, we see two extremes.
在我的经历里面，我们看到两个极端。
On the one hand, we have people who are afraid of talking about the baptism of the Holy Spirit, and so they don't talk about it at all.
在一个极端，有些教会里面一点都不敢提，提到圣灵，提到这个圣灵的浸，就怕得不得了。
And so I describe that as a cemetery.
因此，我就形容他们好像是这个坟墓的墓园。
We don't want to talk about it.
我们不要谈。
Well, on the other extreme,
但是另外一边呢？
It seems like there are also people in the church that's all they can talk about.
还有很多的教会或者基督徒，但他们每次在聚会里面只谈圣灵。
And recently in Taiwan, we've had some very exciting news that through the filling of the Holy Spirit, we can get diamonds from God.
在台湾呢，甚至有些地方，他们这个过激烈的到一种程度，他们认为说，我们被圣灵充满的话，从神那里来有很多的宝物。
And so if that side is a cemetery,
所以一边是那个像墓园墓地一样。
And this other side is a circus.
那这边呢，就好像一个游乐园。
And I pray that the Lord would enable us to avoid either being a cemetery, as well as avoid being a circus.
我常常求神帮助我们，在我们的认识里面，不要让我们在圣灵这件事情上面成为一个墓园，或者成为一个游乐园。
Now at the risk of sort of stirring up the pot.
为了避免我把这个事情搞得这个太复杂。
Let me just share some of my own thoughts with regard to the Holy Spirit, and then we will come to the power that the disciples had, or the boldness that the disciples had.
因此就允求各位允许我再分享我自己对圣灵的认识，然后我们来讲到这个从圣灵的浇灌来看见神给我们大胆。
Of course, if you read the book of Acts, you'll know that this was obviously a major focus upon that Luke brings out in Acts.
当然，如果各位有查考《使徒行传》的话，我们知道作者他强调在这个地方强调很多圣灵的工作。
And if you study it very quickly, you'll notice that Luke uses actually a number of different terms to describe what I believe is actually the same thing.
也因此，如果各位仔细去研读的话，路加用了不同的字。来形容圣灵。
So he would describe it as being baptized by the Holy Spirit.
他会形容这个圣灵被比方说圣灵的浸。
He would describe it as being filled with the Holy Spirit.
路加又形容被圣灵充满。
Describing as the Holy Spirit pouring out onto the disciples or believers.
又形容这个圣灵倾倒在信徒的身上。
And also sometimes describes it as receiving the Holy Spirit.
就形容有些人可以接受承受圣灵。
But we don't have time to look at all of these terms, but I could actually take you through the book of Acts and show you all of these different terms that Luke uses to describe what I believe is, in essence, the same thing.
如果我们有时间的话，我会带各位从头到尾这个整个《使徒行传》来看看路加怎么样用这些字来介绍圣灵。这同样是我自己在神面前的领受。
Now, some people would say, well, each of those terms actually means something different and refers to something different.
有些人认为这些不同的字眼有在不同的这个含义，有不同的意义。
But it would seem to me, at least in my reading, that they're referring in essence to the same thing.
但是在我个人的领受里面，这所有的地方都解释到同样一位。
Now, there are three things about the baptism of the Holy Spirit that I believe are important.
讲到圣灵的浸的时候，有三点非常重要的事情。
First of all, it would seem to me that the baptism of the Holy Spirit is a separate thing from conversion.
圣灵的浸或者受圣灵的浸是接受耶稣基督，是两件不同的事情。
Now, Irvine might not invite me to come back to preach.
我这样想，我相信下次Irvine教会就不邀请我来了。
So I'm taking a great risk here.
所以我就做一个很大胆的尝试。But
it would seem to me that as I read at least the New Testament,
至少当我在读新约的时候,
the filling of the Holy Spirit is a separate experience than
圣灵充满和觉知信主是两个不同的经验。
Let me ask you a question.
那我问一个问题。
We're told here that the disciples were filled with the Holy Spirit. Were they Christians when they were filled with the Holy Spirit? That's not a trick question.
这不是一个假的问题, 要想要骗你。
Were they Christians?
他们是不是基督徒?
Well, let me ask you another question.
或者我问另外一个问题。
Pentecost.
五旬节。
Acts chapter 2.
就是像第二章,
when the Holy Spirit came upon the disciples,
当圣灵临到这些信徒,
were they Christians?
那个时候他们是基督徒吗?
Were they true followers of Jesus Christ?
他们是不是真实跟随耶稣的基督徒呢?
不敢回答。 我替你回答。
I
believe that they were Christians.
我相信他们是基督徒。
Absolutely.
绝对是基督徒。
Absolutely.
没有疑问的。
And so this filling of the Holy Spirit was a separate experience.
受圣灵充满这件事情是一个完全另外的一个经验，一个体验。
Now the timing of when that filling of the Holy Spirit comes upon a person seems to vary.
至于说一个人什么时候会受圣灵的充满，那因人而异。
But what they are describing here is not conversion, but rather it is a separate, a different experience.
但是这里所形容的事情，绝对不是这些人在这边觉知信主。
And I believe that that's important for us to realize.
但是今天晚上我们这里提到这个是非常重要的概念。
Now, before you misunderstand me, let me say you need the Holy Spirit's work in our lives to become convicted and to become a Christian, a follower of Jesus Christ.
但是在各位误解我之前，我必须强调说，我们需要圣灵在我们身上，使我们能够认罪，使我们能够。
No one can become a Christian without the work of the Holy Spirit.
若没有圣灵的工作，没有人会说我要成为一个基督徒，跟随耶稣。
Work of the Holy Spirit is separate from the baptism of the Holy Spirit.
但是圣灵要帮助你，使能够觉知信主，跟这里所形容的圣灵充满是完全不一样的体验。
Second,
第二点。
Not only is it separate from conversion,
不光它是一个不一样的体验。
It is actually an experience that can occur over and over again.
而同时我们看见这样的体验是不止一次的，很可能是多次的。
Now, if you don't believe me, go back to chapter 4.
如果不相信的话，各位回到第四章。
Notice what verse 8 says.
第八节是怎么说的呢？
Then Peter, you remember they're brought before the Sanhedrin.
各位记得在那个时候，彼得被带到那个这些教会的领导人面前，公会的领导人面前。
Then Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said to them.
那时候彼得被圣灵充满。
And so in verse 8, Peter was filled with the Holy Spirit.
所以在第八节的时候，彼得被圣灵充满。
And then in verse 31, we're told again that he's filled with the Holy Spirit.
然后第31节，这里又说他又被圣灵充满。
And so this filling of the Holy Spirit seems to be a recurring thing that can take place in our lives.
因此我们相信，我们也发现这个被圣灵充满这样一个经历，可以是。
With every fresh challenge,
面对各种不同的挑战的时候，都有可能会发生。
God can fill us. God can baptize us. God can pour out His Spirit into our lives.
把他的圣灵加到我们身上。And
so it is a repeated experience.
也可以说，这个被圣充满是一个一直不断持续的一种经历。Third,
very quickly.
第三点。It
is also a visible experience.
同时，被圣灵充满是可以看得到。
If it wasn't visible, how would Luke know that they were filled with the Holy Spirit?
如果一个人被圣灵充满，不被别人所发现或所看见的话，路加又会怎么知道而写下来？
It must have been something that you could see with your eyes.
一定是有一些什么样的现象让别人能够看见。
Well, what does all this have to do with boldness?
但是今天。 以上讲的这三点跟今天晚上说的大胆放胆讲道有什么关系？
Let me quickly lay three things before us this evening.
那么有三方面。
And I pray that they are not just academic.
我希望这不光是一种学术性的研讨。
As I tell you, I believe from the bottom of my heart.
因为我所要说的是从我心里面真正相信。
But the Church of Jesus Christ desperately needs.
今天教会，神的教会必须要了解。
Is a fresh anointing of the Holy Spirit.
必须经历，必须认识的就是神来的全新的圣灵。
The pouring of the Holy Spirit brings three things.
圣灵的浇灌带来三方面。
First of all, I want you to notice that the filling of the Holy Spirit brings certainty to our hearts.
首先，被圣灵充满，它带给一个人的是里面的确据。
It brings certainty to our hearts.
它把一个确据放在人的里面。
We know who we believe.
我们知道我们信的是谁。
And we know that He will guard what we have entrusted Him to that very day. There is a certainty that comes with the filling of the Holy Spirit.
他必保守我们所交托的，直到见他的那日。There
is a wiping away of any doubt in our minds and in our hearts of the validity of the gospel of Jesus Christ when the Holy Spirit comes upon us.
当一个人被圣灵充满，那些所有的疑问、所有的疑虑，一概都被扫开。Can
I use an example very quickly that I think you will understand immediately?
让我做一个很简单的一个例子。
When we talk about missions, of course, our minds go to Matthew chapter 28.
当我们讲到这个宣教的时候，我们常常就想到马太福音第二十八章。We're
most familiar, obviously, with verse 18, 19, and 20.
第十八、十九跟二十节最常听到。But
I wonder if you've ever noticed verse 16 and 17.
但是有没有注意到第十六节跟十七节？There
we're told that the disciples went to the mountain that Jesus told them to go to.
门徒们到山上，耶稣叫他们去的那个地方。And
when they went there, they saw him and they bowed down and worshipped him.
当他们到了那里看见耶稣的时候，他们在耶稣的面前，匍匐敬拜。And
then notice, I wonder if you've ever taken note of verse 17.
各位有没有想到重新再看这第十七节？There's
an amazing statement there.
有一个很让人惊讶的地方。That
for many years I did not understand.
过了许多年，我一直没有办法理解。
Matthew tells us that in the midst of their worship,
在他们敬拜耶稣的时候,
there were some who doubted.
有些人心中怀疑.
There were some who doubted.
有些人心中怀疑.
After all of that,
经历了那么多,
there were still some
who doubted.
Thank goodness we're not told who.
还好我们不晓得到底是谁，但是
40 days later，
40天之后
，at Pentecost when the Holy Spirit came upon，
五旬节的日子圣灵来了
，we see the 11 disciples plus Matthias the 12th，
我们看见11个门徒加上后来一位，总共12个人
，remember they stood up，
他们站起来。
Go back and read chapter 2。
如果我们回到使徒行传第二章
，and you will be struck by the certainty that Peter had。 With regard to what he believed in,
各位会忽然发现，彼得他在那个时候被圣灵充满的时候，他的里面的他那个坚定的程度。
And it was just as if Paul describes it in Ephesians chapter 1, verse 13 and 14. This Holy Spirit is a seal upon the believer.
就好像保罗在以弗所书里面说的，那个圣灵的印记就在他们身上。
And there is a certainty of what we believe.
在这些人身上，他们看到了一个东西，我们看他身上一个东西就是确信。All
doubts are erased.
完完全全的疑惑，通通一扫而空。And
boldness,
并且大胆
comes into place.
开始讲道。And
so there's a certainty.
因此被圣灵充满带来的是一个人他里面的确据。But
secondly,
第二点,
there is also
同时
courage.
被圣灵充满带来的就是那个胆量。
Courage. Can we go back to Peter?
我们回到彼得。
I don't mean to pick on Peter, but he's a good man to pick on.
我们常常在说到彼得，并不是因为他欺负，但是他实在是有很多东西给我们。
Would you describe Peter as a courageous person or a cowardly Christian?
如果你记得彼得这个人，我剩下形容他是个大胆的人，还是个胆小的人。
Well, you would probably say it depends on when you're talking about.
会说那就看情形了。
At least in the Gospels, it would seem to me that by and large, Peter was a timid person. He was a coward. He was a man full of fear.
至少在福音书里面形容的彼得是一个非常胆小。
And you remember that when he had an opportunity to witness for Jesus Christ.
你记得他曾经有一次有一个机会要为主做见证。
Three times over, when he was asked, "Aren't you a follower of Jesus Christ?"
有三次，然后他，你不是那跟随耶稣的吗？
Three times over, Peter says, "I don't know him. I don't know him."
不认识他，我根本不认识他，我根本跟他一点关系都没有。
But then we turn to Acts chapter 2.
然后我们后来又回到了使徒行传第二章的时候。
And Peter is filled with the Holy Spirit.
那个时候彼得被圣灵充满。
And it is with great courage.
那身上有大有胆量。
And confidence.
而且蛮有确据。
That Peter stood up.
彼得站起来。
And that is what comes with the filling of the Holy Spirit.
被圣灵充满，你所得到的也是这样子。
And very quickly, the third.
还有最后第三点。
Not only is there certainty.
不光是一个人有确据。
Not only is there confidence.
不光这个人有这个有绝对的相信。
But there is also confession.
同时他
宣告 confession.
同时他能够宣告。
There is a confession of Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior.
他就能够宣告主耶稣是主是救主。
Now I want to pause there very quickly.
让我在这边暂停一下。
Because it would seem to me that this confession of Jesus Christ is pivotal with regard to the baptism of the Holy Spirit.
因为为什么我要暂停一下呢？因为我强调这样子一个宣告与圣灵的灵境或者是被充满是绝对的关系。
There are many aspects to the work of the Holy Spirit.
圣灵的工作有多面性。
But in regard to the baptism.
但至于这个受圣灵的浸渍。
And the pouring out of the Holy Spirit.
以及被圣灵所充满所倾倒。
It would seem to me that every time that phrase appears.
每一次当这些字眼出现的时候。
It always has something to do with witness.
总是跟见证有关系。
I'm not saying that the Holy Spirit in our lives does not renew us and revive us inwardly.
所以弟兄姐妹们请注意，当然圣灵充满当然是要提升我们，帮助我们，让我们能够更坚定。
It does that.
当然。
But
但是
it does much more than that.
更有甚者。
And in fact, I would say that the first principal work of the baptism of the Holy Spirit is actually for witness.
我相信圣灵要充满我们最重要最主要的原因就是让我们能够宣告他的名。
And so if somebody was to come to Jamie Taylor this evening,
如果今天有人要到蒋元的面前来
and said, oh, I've been filled with the Holy Spirit.
你说我已经被圣灵充满了。
I will not ask you whether you fell backwards or you fell forward.
我不会问你说你被圣灵充满的时候是往前倒还是
往后倒。And I won't even ask you as we do in Taiwan, did you have gold dust that came down when you were filled with the Holy Spirit?
金粉。但是今天在台湾有一些地方祷告，这个被圣充满的时候，从天上降下金粉在。
And in fact, I will not ask you whether you have a private prayer language that when you're filled with the Holy Spirit, you pray it.
我也不会问你说，你当你被圣灵充满的时候，你是不是能够讲方言
？What I will ask is this.
但是我却会问你这个。
Are you witnessing for Jesus?
当你被圣灵充满的时候。你有没有感觉你有更多的能力能够为主宣扬他的道
？Because that, brothers and sisters,
因为那一件
is the primary purpose of the pouring
圣灵降临充满你的最主要的原因。
Where did the boldness of the disciples come?
门徒们大胆放胆的泉源来自于何处
？No,
we looked at three things.
我们今天看到了三方面。
Three areas that enabled them
能够让他们
not to be cowardly Christians,
不再成为只是一个胆小的基督徒
but courageous Christians,
反而成为一个勇敢的基督徒。
We've talked about the presence of Jesus.
我们提到耶稣的同在。
His modeling presence.
他作为我们的表率。
His molding presence.
他作为我们塑造我们。
His motivating presence.
他激励我们。
My friends, brothers and sisters,
弟兄姐妹们
if you lack boldness, could I tell you this?
如果你今天晚上仍觉得你没有那个胆量，让我这么说
go home and spend time in the presence of Jesus.
回去花点时间与主耶稣同在一处
spend time in the presence of Jesus.
花点时间与他在一处
allow His presence to come in a very visible
让他的同在来到你这里
to once again rekindle our hearts.
让他能够重新在你里面燃起
boldness is not something that we sort of just grit our teeth and
放胆 is not simply not being afraid of losing your face.
But rather it comes when we are in the presence of Jesus.
但更重要的是让我们能够重新的常常的来到神的同在当中。
And so when you and I are tempted to be timid about sharing the gospel.
有时候我们就很胆小的时候。
Let us run back to the presence.
让我们是赶快跑回快跑回
到他的同在。And allow His modeling presence, His molding presence.
然后看见他的作为表率，他作为我们的这个塑造，他作为我们的鼓励。
To give us boldness.
给我们胆量，来见证他自己。
We've talked about the power of God.
我们又谈到神的能力。
How big is your God today?
你今天神在你里面有多大？你相不相信你的神是那创造宇宙的神？还是你的神是一个某个小地方的小小的神明？
Oh, I pray that God would give us a fresh and enlarged vision of how great our God is. I believe that if we grow in that awareness,
of how great our God is.发现他的创造能力
his controlling power,
他的掌控的能力
as well as his confirming,
以及他的确立你的能力
we'll have a boldness, my friend,
我们就自然的涌流出来从我们里面对他的那种放胆张大的信心我们就讲到我们要回到神的面前
it comes from Jesus's presence.
它来自于耶稣基督的同在
it comes from God's power.
来自大胆放胆来自于神的能力
but then thirdly, it comes from the pouring out.
放胆来自于承受圣灵的浇灌。
And I pray that tonight you will experience that fresh pouring out.
但愿我们每个人都承受圣灵的浇灌。
Perhaps you're here this evening and you are not a Christian.
也许在座今天听到的人里面有人还不是基督徒。
And you're probably wondering what is this all about?
你在想说你们到底讲的是什么？
Why do you Christians need?To have such boldness.
为什么你们基督徒需要放胆去讲道？
Why do you have to talk about the presence of Jesus, the power of God?
为什么你们要提到神耶稣同在、上帝的能力还有圣灵的浇灌？
Well, I want to tell you this evening.
今天晚上我要怎么说？
It is of the most utter importance.
对我们来说这是多么的重要。
Because we're told actually here in chapter 4.
因为在第四章里面。
That in heaven and above.
在天上。
And on earth below.
在地下
there is no other name
没有任何一个名
by which you and I can be saved.
我们能够靠着得救
Why do Christians have to be bold?
为什么基督徒必须放胆
Because Jesus Christ
因为耶稣基督
is the way
是只有他
the truth
是那道路真理
and the life
和生命
There is no other way that you and I can get to heaven.
你与我没有第二条路能够到父那里
去 Save through Jesus Christ.
除了透过耶稣基督给我们这条路
I don't care what your background might be.
我不管你的背景是什么
I don't, it does, it's regardless of what our education
也不管你的学问的程度
it might, it's regardless of how moral you and I have perhaps sought to be.
甚至也不在乎你与我之间的这个道德标准有什么差异
The Bible tells us that all have sinned.
因为圣经上告诉我们每一个人都是罪人
of the glory of God.
我们都亏欠了神的荣耀
And so if you have not accepted Jesus Christ this evening,
因此若有人在我们中间还没有完全接受耶稣基督做你个人
It is not with arrogance and pride that I tell you
但愿你们不接受不是因为别的可能是因为你自己
But rather it is with boldness that I want to tell you
靠着这个里面的胆量我要告诉你
That you have to accept Jesus Christ.
你必须接受耶稣基督做你个人的救主。
Open up your heart.
把你的心敞开。
Acknowledge that you are a sinner.
承认你在他面前是一个不达标的罪人。
Accept Jesus Christ.
接受耶稣基督做你个人的救主。
And experience not only eternal life.
从那开始，你能够经历他永恒的生命。
But also experience a transformed life.
更重要的是能够经历一个改变的生命。
Let's bow our heads.
让我们一起。低头祷告。
Father, thank you for this.
天父，我们感谢你今天晚上的时间。
Thank you for these wonderful verses that describe for us.
感谢主在这几节经节里面给我们看见。
The reason for the effectiveness of the early church.
在早期。
Turning the world upside down.
早期教会能够改变世界的原因。
Lord, it was from their boldness.
从他们的胆量。
Their boldness.To witness.
从他们能够为你放胆宣道的那个胆量上。
Lord, thank you for these three pictures that you have set before us this evening.
主，我们感谢你今天晚上给我们看见三幅图画。
The source of their boldness.
他们胆量的源头。
Lord, that boldness did not come from themselves.
那个胆量不是来自于他们的学问。
But rather it came from Jesus's presence.
而是来自于你的同在。
Their conviction of God's power.
他们确定的知道你是那创造的 神,
and the receiving of the pouring out of the Holy Spirit. Lord, I pray that those three pictures would speak into my life and into the life of each one here this evening. Lord, as we close this service this evening, or there might be some here who have not accepted Jesus Christ. And your word tells us that he is indeed the only way. That there is no other way that we can receive salvation, save through the name of Jesus Christ. And so, Lord, if there would be any here in our midst who is not a Christian this evening,
因此若在我们中间有人还没有成为基督徒,
you would open up their hearts.
求主打开他们的心,
and Lord, that we would confess our need for a Savior.
让我们在神面前承认我们需要救主,
and we would receive Jesus Christ.
也让我们能够甘心乐意地接受耶稣做主,
and Lord, from this day forward,
从今天,
we would live for him.
我们为他而活,
hear our prayers.
求主听我们的祷告,
in Christ's name.
我们祷告奉耶稣基督的名。
Amen.